the word for you, and I'm Pastor Aminata. This is some deep stuff, isn't it? All right? But I still got my Berean hat on. Okay? Or do you? But let's get back to our teaching, and first let's go over our running scripture, Luke 9:23. And then he said to the crowd, if any of you want to be my follower, you must turn from your selfish ways, take up your cross daily, and follow me. And the verse that corresponds with our thought on Matthew 7:23. And then I will declare to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness. So, basically, who is Jesus talking about when he says, you who practice lawlessness? For the most part, he's talking about people who said they would follow him, but they never did it. They never followed Christ. They followed another way. They followed another teaching. They followed what someone told them without them searching the scriptures for themselves, all right? They confessed Jesus as Lord with their lips, but they never made him Lord in their heart. They never obeyed his teaching, right? We got some dedicated and committed people that go to church. They're not dedicated and committed to the will of God. They're dedicated and committed to the institution, to the pastor. Lord, let it not be some big name person. I'm not trying to put nobody down. I'm just saying like it is. And they, yet, even though they say they call him Lord, but they've never surrendered themselves to his lordship. All right, and what that means, it really means just what he says. If anyone will follow after me, let him deny himself, all right? Take up his cross daily and follow me. I mean, this is the mandate. Deny, take up your cross daily and follow me. Do as I did. This is not about you. So you got to let go all your desires, all your wants, all your wills. This is what I want. This is what I want to pursue. But you don't understand, Lord. Your preacher was preaching such a good message. And he said, and that is not going to get you into heaven. Sorry, either you will obey or you won't obey. You can get into the word to find out for yourself, or you can continue to buy into that teaching. But I'm just here to tell you, that is a false gospel. These are people who all, though they call him Lord, like I said, they never made him Lord. Jesus said, if you desire to enter the kingdom of heaven, all right, if you really want to enter into the kingdom of heaven, don't just call me Lord. Make me Lord and do the things that I say do. Don't just call him Lord. Make him Lord and show it. It's not even about the things that we say. It's more about the things that we do, all right, that brings truth and relevance to the words that we say. John 8:43 says this, why do you not understand my speech? Even because you cannot hear my word. See, our greed and our selfishness will block our ability to understand the intricacies of what Jesus is trying to get across to us. Mm-hmm. Because self is blocking the way. I ain't trying to hear this. I don't care what she's saying. It's wrong. It's wrong. I'm not feeling that. We're good at saying that anyway. You know what? I'm sorry, but I'm just not feeling that word. Hello, that's on you. Ain't my words. It's in the Bible. Revelation 3:20. We know it well. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open up the door, I will come to him and will sup with him and him with me. Jesus is standing at the door of your heart. He's knocking. You going to open up the door for him? That's a question for you to answer. Mark 10:24. This amazed them. But Jesus said again, dear children, listen to this. Dear children, it is very hard to enter the kingdom of God. These are Jesus' words. Dear children, it is very hard to enter the kingdom of God. No one ever in my whole growing up, and I grew up in the church, I never ever heard anyone teach or preach that it's very hard to enter into the kingdom of God. I've never heard that, and my heart grieves. because I'm saying, oh my God, how many people are going to miss the mark thinking that they're going to get in and they're not going to get in? That's what makes me sad when I think about it, and even sad for myself, because, Lord, I just want to do your will, and I want to know that I'm doing your will. I'm not doing my own thing, all right? I'm willing to give it all up, sacrifice everything. I just want to do the will of my Father, all right? So, but Jesus is saying that in that day, there will be many who will call him Lord. He's going to say, I never knew you. You never established a relationship with me. I am sorry, but you will not be entering in. And you don't want to find yourself among them. The book of Acts 14:22 says this. Where they strengthen the believers. They encourage them to continue in the faith. Reminding them that we must suffer. Listen. That reminding them that we must suffer many hardships to enter the kingdom of God. Like I said. No. They don't tell us these things. That we must suffer many hardships to enter. And why is it hardships? Because we got to deny ourselves. Why is it hardships? Because I can't do what I want to do when I want to do it and where I want to do it. That's why. That we must suffer many hardships because I got to let go of my wants, my desires, my goals, my aspirations in order to do the will of God. That's why. We must suffer many hardships. There may be times when you will go without. All right? There may be times when you won't be able to benefit while you watch other people. Because the enemy going to put it in your mind. While other people, as you believe, are being blessed. You say, well, Lord, what's happening to me? I know that, right? Hebrew, listen, 4:6 says this. So God's rest is there for people to enter. But those who first heard this good news failed to enter because they disobeyed God. God's rest is there for people to enter. All right? That's what it's saying. But those who first heard the good news, they failed to enter because they disobeyed God. It's about either being obedient, because there's no in between. You either obey or you are being disobedient. Hebrew, again, 6:4, for it is impossible to bring back to repentance. I really need you to read it for yourselves. For it is impossible to bring back to repentance those who were once enlightened, those who have experienced the good things of heaven and shared in the Holy Spirit, 6:5, who have tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the power of the age to come, Hebrews 6:6, and who then turn away from God. It is impossible to bring such people back to repentance by rejecting the Son of God. They themselves are nailing him to the cross once again and holding him up for public shame. That's the ultimate definition of a backslider. Those who have tasted of the goodness of God. And yet, they decided that they were not going to no longer follow Jesus, but they're going to follow. I think I'm going to get mine right now. Right? So, you know, they've been blessed with material things and blessed with good fortune, blessed with maybe a little popularity, blessed maybe even fame, blessed with wealth. Just pay attention. But they turned away from what Jesus has called them to do. And Revelation 3:5. And all who are victorious will be clothed in white. I will never erase their names from the book of life. But I will announce before my Father and his angels that they are mine. I will announce those who are obedient. Those who are obeying the will of God. Those who have made Jesus their Lord in their life. More when I come back. This is deep stuff. This is scary stuff. But this is good stuff. This is stuff I believe is going to set somebody free. Y'all hang with me and share this with a friend. I'm Pastor Aminata. God has a word.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know, because right now you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.